Kosu Rehabilitation Hospital is a specialized surgical facility that focuses on the surgical correction and rehabilitation of orthopedic problems, which account for over 50% of the patients served. About 45% of those served receive plastic surgery and burns treatment. The hospital treats approximately 5,000 accident victims a year and 150 to 200 per day. Kosu Hospital publicist Dorothy Mutabazi says once children are brought early for treatment, the challenges can be reversed, moreover, cheaper. She says, unfortunately, parents sometimes wait until the child is 10 or 12, making recovery difficult and more expensive. Mutabazi told parents to stop hiding away children born with disabilities. Some parents have been known to do this out of fear of stigma from society.
But also the children born with disability, there are so many. And from the traditional setting, people with disability have been seen as a curse. Other parents tend to hide them because they are scared of what the community has to say about them. And that creates a big need. Something that would have been treated with at a relative low price, someone comes like something like clubfoot, which would be treated with low income treatment. Someone keeps the child up to 10, 12 years and they have to undergo a very expensive surgery or continuous procedures for something very small.
Mutabazi also noted that increase in road accidents is overwhelming the hospital. The treatments involve fitting the road accident victims with artificial limbs.
With the current road accident increase, we have seen an increase in disability. The accidents are so many, so you see lots of fractures coming up. You see very many people who have lost arms and limbs. So, yes, the increase in the accident also increases our patient numbers.
Chantel Nachanzi, who is currently taking care of her brother who got involved in an accident, has asked for help from well-wishers. She says they are struggling to get money for treatment.
He was with my mom and dad. They were traveling to our home. And then they got this accident. But mom and dad, they realized much pain and they were injured seriously, but Akim wasn't injured at all. Until 2020, when we realized that his leg got a damage, which was to be operated, thinking of cancers in his leg, eating his bones. So we were told to come to this hospital, but the amount they requested for his surgery was too much for us to afford. So in due course, my mom was to collect the money because we lost our dad in 2020, whereby she was not capable of collecting that much money. Till now, he's in pain and he needs more care, which needs a lot of money.
Santosh Gumte, the CEO of Plascon Paints, offered to donate paint worth 50 million shillings to the hospital.
Fantastic work by way of surgery and rehabilitation, especially for the children. And I'm very, very pleased and very happy. I have taken a tour of the premises, and this is some really excellent. I was very impressed with the 3D printing that is available here. I've seen it for the first time. So Kosu is really quite advanced, and the staff that they have are really very good.
So through partnerships with clubs like Mongas and companies like Plascon, we hope we can raise awareness both in the sports community and the public at large that many of these services do exist at Kosu. So please do not rush to go to our neighbors when Kosu is here.
Report by Godfrey Sempija for the news in Entebbe.